Hello and welcome to another episode of my Beginner's Guide to Setting Up Todoist. My name is Carl Pauline, and this week, this episode, it's all about settings, because we need to know all the different things we can change within Todoist so that you get the most out of this incredible application. Now, in episode one, we covered setting up a few projects and hopefully you did do your homework. So now you have a number of projects set up. And also in the last episode, episode two, we went through the different tasks that you can do and what you can do with tasks. And hopefully you've now got used to clearing your inbox and you've collected tasks. And as soon as you collect them, and when you have a bit of time, I should say later in the day, you can then move those tasks to your various projects. Hopefully you've got all that set up now. So what we need to do now is just take you into the wonderful world of Todoist settings so that you can start customizing Todoist a little bit so that you get the most out of this incredible application. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you would like to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using this incredible application Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you in to my demo account so I can show you all that you need to know about settings. Okay, so last episode we went into adding dates and flags to your tasks. And in the previous episode to that, we dealt with managing your projects. Now, before we go any further, what I want to do is to take you into the settings, because there's a few things that you may want to change in there that can affect how Todoist works. Now, to get to your settings, you go to the gear icon up here. Now, you can obviously from the top, you can start with sync, but Todoist will automatically sync every time you start it, and it generally automatically syncs every few minutes anyway. You don't necessarily need to change that. You can also change the theme. Now, you can click on that and you get a few options. Now, I'm using a pro account, so I get a few different extra options here. But what you want to do, so the extra options I should point out are these ones with the stars. So the ones without the stars are the options that you have. So you can go into a very dark mode, which is like a noir. It's not quite dark, but you can go into noir, which will give you a black theme, as you can see up here. So the trim, if you like, is black. For those of you who like dark mode, you can actually go into a dark mode, and Todoist dark mode is actually very, very good. As you can see from here, the colors really stand out and it is quite vibrant. But you have a number of options with your theme, so you can change your theme and go through those. I'm going to go back to the Todoist color because that's the one I'm more familiar with. So that's the first thing that you may want to change. You may want to change the theme of your Todoist. Going back into the gear icon, we'll go to the settings. Now, this is where you get to change a number of items. So up here, you have your personal information and you can change your name. You can add a photo. You can change your edit your email address, which you may or may want to do. You may want to connect social accounts to it, so it's easier to go in. And you can actually refer friends and you'll get 2 months free Todoist Premium, which is really nice. You can also delete your Todoist account, which will require your password. So that's the main one about the account. Now, the general is where you really want to go. So let's go into here. For language, of course, you can set your language. The start page really is, you can use, I've got filters here, which is a paid version because this is a demo account. But I can actually have my today, or I can use upcoming. It's currently set for today, or I can actually have my one of my projects. So you can click on that and it will, which means that whenever you open up Todoist, it will start whatever you want to show. I'm quite happy leaving it today, so we'll do that. Smart date recognition. So that was when I was showing you in the dates that if you type in MON for Monday, it will automatically recognize Monday as the date. Now you can change that. You can say, no, you don't want to use it. But you know, for me, I find I've got so used to it, it's great. Automatic accept invites. That one is from people who you may be sharing projects with, and you can change your date format and time zone here. You can also change the start of the week. So if you prefer to start the week on a Sunday, you can start it on a Sunday. Maybe you want to start the week on a Saturday. So wherever you want to actually start the week, you can actually choose the day there. Next week refers to the date picker. So if you're going to start something next week, you can actually change the date. So next week could be any of those days that you wish, and weekend, whether Saturday or Sunday. Now, here you get email. So the newsletter, it says, yes, notify me about updates. And occasionally I do get a newsletter from Todoist, but they don't usually send that many out. But the daily digest means that you actually get a list of all your tasks for the day emailed to you every morning. Now, this is great if you are one of those people who works in a company who are really strict on your security. So you can't have Todoist on your computer or anything like that. What you can do is get them to email you a list of all your tasks for the day, and then you can just print it out and you can cross things off as you do them and then update your Todoist later. So there's a few things that you can do right there. Let's just close out of that and go back to subscription. So this, you can tell, is your subscription. So I'm not actually on... Oh, I'm on a free Todoist. I didn't realize that. I thought I was on a paid Todoist, but there you go. I'm on a free Todoist here. The theme we've done, karma points, is something that I'm going to cover in a later episode. So we won't go into that too much details now. Notifications. Now this one, web notifications, yes, notify me on the web. This is if you've got tasks that are due, and you can have all, you can set these up however way you want to do them. Integration relates to things that you may want to connect. Now, one of the things that you may want to connect is your Google Calendar, but again, that can be quite messy and I wouldn't necessarily recommend that just yet, but you can connect your Google Calendar, or you can actually have here, you can connect your Todoist calendar, you can actually do a calendar feed as well. So there's a few things that you can actually do from there. And that's really all you need to know about with your settings. So the main ones that you may want to change at this stage is the theme. So you can go into there and change your theme. You may want to change some of the settings in here, the general. Just have a look and have an experiment and see what you like and what you don't like. And as I say, karma points is something that I will come to in another episode because it's quite detailed and you can actually change quite a few things in there. So hopefully that's given you a good overview of the settings. It's worth having a look at and trying to set things up how you want to set it up because it will really help you to get really familiar with Todoist. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.